It's the Porsche Carrera Cup in France, and we're at the famous Paul Ricard circuit. Just under 4 kilometers long, this circuit. One of France's most famous. On pole, Mathieu Jaminet has already wrapped up the title. Number 55 is Nicolas Misselin, who is the teammate of Mathieu Jaminet. Just behind him as well, Dylan De Dela, the Belgian rider of Belgium Racing. Another pole position for Jaminet. Well, he secured the title at Imola last time out. There he is in the 48, the champion, Mathieu Jaminet. The Martinet by Almera's team. So he's been victorious in Barcelona, at Spa, at Zandvoort, Le Mans, and Imola last time out. So the Paul Ricard circuit is to come in the Porsche Carrera Cup. Expecting a challenge as well from Vincent Beltoise of the Saint-Luc team. Julien Andlauer ahead of him as well, second on the grid. There we have it. There's the grids. Jaminet one, Andlauer and Beltoise are expected to be the challengers. They're second and third on the grid, respectively. Geoffrey Denada, as well as Sebastian Loeb Racing Team, is fourth. Jim Pla of the Racing Technology makes up the top five. And there we look at the top 25 on the grid. Hans Fabry of Team Racert down at the bottom. Well, it is a wonderful circuit, this, the Paul Ricard circuit at Le Castellet. 3.841 kilometres in total. A wonderful season, and what a place to end it as well, at the Paul Ricard. Well, the drivers just gone through their warm-ups, but Jaminet, number 48, behind him, number 555, Andlauer, number 7, Beltoise, 9, Denada, 85, Thomas Laurent, Jim Pla as well, the number 22. Jostling for position right away. Great start from Jaminet, but he's got a couple right on his tail. Andlauer and Beltoise.
Lorsque l'on part à 25, il y a toujours un petit peu plus de difficultés et le dégât. En tout cas, le départ, on l'a bien vu, a été très...
That's number 17.
Attention pour le...
That's not a good start at all for Wim Mulders of the Speed Lover team. Jaminet, Beltoise, Andlauer. Pla making up the top five. Denada is currently fourth. You can see Jaminet just about half a second, or just under, ahead of Beltoise at the moment. But it's pretty much as we were. A fast start from Jaminet, swept all before him this season. There we are around the first chicane. Beltoise just trying to outmaneuver his teammate there, Andlauer. The Saint-Aloc teammates neck and neck at the moment, headed by Andlauer, but Beltoise just behind him there, you can see. And he tries again to come on the inside. That's going to be a battle between those two. Beltoise just ahead of Andlauer in the standings. He's fourth after Imola. Andlauer fifth. Currently, Jaminet, 218 points post Imola. That is the battle for second between Andlauer and Beltoise. Just to update you as well, that Geoffrey Denada is currently second in the standings post Imola, with Florian Latour in third place. 10 points the difference between those two. Beltoise in fourth with Andlauer fifth. Thomas Laurent just outside the top five in the current standings. Jaminet, though, a long way ahead. Number 22 in your picture is Jim Pla. And he's got the number 9 behind him. That is Denada. It's going to be an interesting one as well between Denada and Plat. Since there's going to be a battle brewing throughout the course of the day there. Denada tries again to overtake Plat. No, and he might have done it. No, maybe not. Plat just about holds him off. So that currently is the battle for fourth place at the moment. They're 6 seconds down already on Jaminet. Jaminet has a lead of just over 2 seconds from Andlauer. Beltoise now over 3 seconds adrift. As we head towards the fourth lap, Jaminet well in control, as he has been throughout the course of the season. Nicolas Misselin that in your picture is Andlauer. Mislan down in 8th at the moment. Latour in 7th. Latour, remember, currently 3rd in the standings. But again, that battle. Pla is doing his best there to hold off Donada. Donada, though, is coming. And right behind them as well is Thomas Laurent, the 85 Laurent of Martinet by Almeras team. Same team as Jaminet. And Jim Pla. Not quite. Well, Donada just about held him off there, but Pla, I think, is going to do it here. Yeah, Pla. After much jostling, Pla has now overtaken Donada again. I thought Donada had him there. What a manoeuvre that was from Donada, but then he oversteered. The gap 3.5 seconds now between Jaminet and Julien Andlauer. And Beltoise is nearly 5 seconds off the pace now as we head towards the fifth lap. Number 10 as well. Thomas Laurent. And Florian Latour is right there in your picture as well, in the number 10. Latour over 11 seconds off the lead though at the moment, 11.170 off the pace. But it's very, very congested from 4th all the way down to 9th. In 9th at the moment, Alexandre Juenem. But 4th, Donada, down to 9th place, Juenem. Very, very congested. Only a couple of seconds separating 6 riders there. Or 6 drivers, rather. But 4 seconds ahead, Jaminet. Number 12 in your picture now as well is Jom Schmidt-Stader. Schmidt-Stader. A little group there as well, involving the number 44 Laurent Pignon of Racing Technology. Denis Papin as well. Little cluster of 4 or 5 cars there. Those riders are currently outside the top 10 at present, so not going to trouble the leads. But that gap I mentioned a few moments ago between 4th and 9th stretched out to 4 seconds now. It was 2.5 a moment or so ago. But no changes from the top five on the grid as they started. Thomas Laurent has dropped a few places, but as we can see on lap seven, Jaminet now 5.6 seconds ahead of And Lauer. As well at the moment is still the top three on the grid, And Lauer, Beltoise, second and third respectively at present, and all of a sudden there's a big gap opening up to Geoffrey Denada, who is still fourth. He's though almost 11 and a half seconds off Jaminet at the moment as we head towards lap eight. Mislat still ninth in the number 55, 14 seconds off the lead at the moment. And that lead is stretching. Oh, I beg your pardon, Mislat. 20 seconds now off the pace. Jaminet, his lead now over 6 seconds from And Lauer. And Lauer has nearly 3 seconds on Beltoise, and he's gone. Christophe Lapierre of Sebastian Loeb Racing is out. Oh, what a shame for Lapierre. Oh, it was a terrible mistake, and he was passed there as well by Alexandre Gaidy. Christophe Lapierre, seventh in the standings before this race. He was only 11th on the starting grid. At seventh in the standings, that's a big mistake from Lapierre. He's picked up points throughout the season, Lapierre. He came into the Paul Ricard, seventh place on 87 points. Dylan Dedela as well, 99. And Roar Lindland. Lapierre, in fact, is back in. He did spin out, but it's cost him a lot of places. He's down in 13th at the moment, Lapierre. That's not going to do his final standing any good. There he is, whizzing round that chicane. There he is, Lapierre, the rear of your picture. Well, there's Jaminet. Well, he's got the track to himself at the moment. 8.3 seconds clear of And Lauer. That is some gap, and it looks to be stretching as well. He's over 10 seconds clear of Beltoise, who still occupies third place. You can see the gap now between Jaminet and Lauer. Beltoise will still fancy his chances of a second place finish. It very much is the battle for second, barring catastrophe for Mathieu Jaminet. He's going to win at the Paul Ricard. He won both races at Imola. He's won all seas, hasn't he? As Jaminet. But one of the surprises at Imola was Geoffrey Denarder. He didn't finish the second race. There's Jürgen Schmidt-Stader. No major changes at the moment in the top 10. It's an interesting battle, that, between Schmidt-Stader and Pierre Piron. But back to the front, second and third. And Beltoise is actually closing the gap a little bit on his teammate. Right behind him, you can see barely a second in that at the moment. And Denarder will also fancy his chances of a podium place. He'll be keen to make up for his Imola disappointment. Well, in the second race anyway. Finished second, Denarder at Imola. He's currently second in the standings as well. And Lauer, though, on course for a second successive second place finish. He was second at Imola in the second race there. But he's some way behind Jaminet. The gap nearly 10 seconds now on lap 11. There's Denarder. In fact, that last race at Imola, it was the only race this season. He hasn't picked up any points, Denarder. A largely impressive season for him. Nine seconds between Jaminet and Andlauer. In fact, Andlauer has made up some ground. He's distanced himself rather from Beltoise. Beltoise, though, does have a chance of climbing into the top three at the end of the season standings if he can maintain this position. He can leapfrog Latour, who is down at the moment in sixth place. Latour. So Florian Latour could lose his top three standing if this stays like it is. There's another little group, Alexandre Gaidai as well, plus with a 99, which is Dylan Derela. And this is the battle for 10th, in fact. And that is Roland Berville. Well, you can see Denarder is actually closing in on Beltoise. Beltoise needs to hold third spot. Was a mistake as well. Stefan Rekopf. Rekopf 15th on the grid at the start, but that was a big error. Beltoise has now gained some ground on Donada. Well, as long as Donada finishes where he currently is, he's going to maintain second place in the standings. Still on points. The top five on the grid remains the top five in the race. Jaminet. And Lauer, Beltoise, Donada, Pla. Pierre struggling at the rear after spinning out right at the back of your screen. That's Dadela of Belgium Racing. Guy Dai is currently occupying 10th spot. Dadela. Oh, he's pushing for a top 10 spot, Dadela. Jaminet, the gap now 12 seconds, over 12 seconds in fact, from Andlauer. Andlauer is also gaining more time ahead of Beltoise. The gap is also closing between Beltoise and Donada. Donada just over a second behind Beltoise now. There's a big gap, in fact, between Donada and Jim Pla. Pla doesn't look like he's going to get a podium finish here. He's well off the pace. But Andlauer looking relatively comfortable. He hasn't lost any time, put it that way, on Beltoise. Jaminet well clear, and he's stretching his lead over Andlauer, but Andlauer just about holding off Beltoise at the moment. Still got that 2 second cushion. But Donada really is challenging Beltoise here. Could be the big mover. Donada could well find himself on the podium if things continue. 13.6 seconds the gap. Jaminet to Andlauer. Just to let you know as well that Jaminet's average speed, 155 kilometres an hour. So he really is travelling at some pace. There's Roger Gruvels of Team Racearts in 21st position. So he's not going to be challenging for the podium anytime soon. Gruvels. Started 16th on the grid, but dropped five places. He's in a race of one at the moment, Gruvels. Nobody around him. Gruvels. He's at one place behind Stefan Rekopf at the moment. Into the last 3 minutes at the Paul Ricard circuit. In your picture is Dedela in 11th place at the moment, but trying desperately to close in on Gaidai. The battle for 10th will be interesting. Gaidai and Dedela. Donada is also closing the gap on Beltoise, who in turn is closing the gap on Andlauer at the moment. Gap under 2 seconds between second and third. Welcome back as well to Lapierre, who is climbing after his earlier mistake. But there's a whole host of four drivers there who are hoping to make the top 10. Currently occupied by Gaidai, but he's got three challengers there who are hoping to take his place in that top 10. Around the chicane. Gaidai is currently 11th in the overall standings. Well, there's the leader, Jaminet. Now he's about to pass Denis Papin. And he has, so he's overlapped Papa. Jaminet 16.7 seconds clear of Andlauer at the moment. And Beltoise is rapidly closing on Andlauer. And in turn, Donada is rapidly closing on Beltoise. So second, third and fourth at the moment is extremely tight. One of them is going to miss out on a podium. Right, the last lap. Well, there's your race leader and the champion. Another victory for Mathieu Jaminet. Flashes his lights in celebration. Mathieu Jaminet has done it again, like he has done all season. The champion wins again at the Paul Ricard circuit. And Andlauer has finished second. He's held off Beltoise. And Beltoise has only just held off Donada. Donada was rapidly closing in on Beltoise, but... And Thomas Laurent has just missed out on a top five finish as well. He was closing in on Jim Plaat. But it's as you were. Latour down in seventh. But Mathieu Jaminet has done it again. Race two of the Porsche Carrera Cup France. Mathieu Jaminet did the business in race one at the Paul Ricard circuit and the season finale on the GT Tour. But Jaminet has been imperious all season. Once again, qualified in first. So your starting grids. Jaminet, Andlauer, Beltoise, Donada, Laurent, Plaat, top six. Latour, seven. Juvenem, eighth. Mislan, ninth. Lindland, tenth. And a big problem as well for John de Wilde of Speed Lover in the 37. What on earth has happened to John de Wilde already in race two? Terrible start for him and the Speed Lover team. So a good result in the race one for Andlauer and Beltoise, who finished on the podium behind Jaminet. And there is the grid. Donada, Laurent, Plaat, Latour, Juvenem, Mislin and Lindland make up the top 10. Mathieu Jaminet, of course, in the 48 on pole. So Florian Latour as well, before the Paul Ricard weekend, was third in the standings behind Geoffrey Donada. So this is a crucial race to determine the final positioning of the season. So Donada, I think, looks set for second place overall after Paul Ricard. But Latour could still be overhauled by Beltoise if Beltoise finishes well on the second race. Latour needs to do pretty well to maintain his place. So John de Wilde here. Well, there they are. Worshipping the sunshine of the Paul Ricard circuit. Certainly a very famous circuit. There's Lapierre. Lapierre recovered very well in race one after a bad error. And he'll be in need of a strong finish. Lapierre currently seventh in the standings. Lapierre finished seventh in both races, in fact, in Imola. Last time out. He's usually around there, but he has finished a little bit higher than that on occasion this season. He's either been sixth or seventh normally. But Jaminet, well, the title's done and dusted. There he is in the 48. Just makes it look easy, does Mathieu Jaminet. He'll be hoping to wrap up the season in style. Jaminet, Andlauer, Beltoise, Denada, Laurent are the top five. From qualifying, they make up the top five on the grid. Jaminet, good start from the champion. So 25 cars departing from the grid. The only one who didn't finish race one was Roland Berville. Wonder how many will finish race two. Thomas Laurent is shot up to third place at the moment. Not a great start for Denada. Thomas Laurent is going extremely well. He's up to fourth. Denada has dropped to fifth at the moment. Jaminet nearly 3 seconds ahead of Andlauer after two laps at the Paul Ricard circuit. In your picture, number 99. Tadela. Tadela finished just outside the top 10 in race one. Oh, and a collision there. I think it's Lapierre. And also, yeah, it's the number 12 again, Jom Schmidtstader. Yeah, it was with Lapierre again. Lapierre had his troubles in race one as well. Yeah, coming together there between Lapierre and Jom Schmidtstader. Yeah, that's the big battle at the moment. It's between Thomas Laurent and Geoffrey Denada. Denada started fourth on the grids, Laurent fifth, but that's the opposite way round at the moment. But the gap is literally 0.3 seconds or so at the moment between those two drivers. The top three look away, So Jaminet has a 3 second advantage over Andlauer at the moment. Beltoise still third. Plaer is still sixth, as he was on the grid, and good run as well by Mislat is seventh at the moment. Latour is eighth after starting seventh, and Gaidai as well started 12th, but he's in the top 10. Juenem down a place to ninth at the moment. Mislan now down to eighth. Latour back to seventh where he started. So the top seven is as you were, except for Laurent and Donada. Well, about 22 and a half minutes to go. Paul Ricard circuit. Currently on the fourth lap. That's Roger Gruels and Van der Grijsbader as well. Battle between three and four. And also the 14 in that three-man cluster, Koen Wouters. Those three around about the 15th, 16th and 17th position at the moment. So that's a little battle going on there. Lapierre doing his best to try and climb the grid at the moment. There's Stefan Rekov. Rekov started 15th on the grids. He'll be hoping to maintain that. Rekov. And the problem again. Number 12, Jom Schmidtstader, is having real issues in the number 12. And he looks to me like he's not going to finish. Jom Schmidtstader. Yeah, it was that collision with Lapierre for Jom Schmidtstader, and Schmidtstader looks as if he's going to crash out. I don't think he's going to be continuing. But that's the interesting battle. And in fact, Laurent and Donada closing in on Beltoise. Beltoise is not looking too great at the moment. Only about 0.4 seconds ahead, rather, of Laurent. 0.7 ahead of Donada. Beltoise is looking vulnerable. Andlauer looks absolutely clear. He looks like he's going to take second. But there's a very intriguing battle going on for third place at the moment between Beltoise, Laurent and Donada. Beltoise fourth in the standings before the Paul Ricard weekend. Beltoise will be hoping to secure a podium finish overall for the season. Thomas Laurent, Geoffrey Donada. That is the battle at the moment, although they are rapidly closing on Beltoise. There's Lapierre. And there's Chaminet. He has a lead of 4.3 seconds at the moment on lap 7. Looking very, very comfortable, Chaminet. .7 now ahead of Andlauer. Andlauer fifth in the standings overall heading into the weekend. I think he's unlikely to advance on that. I think he's too far behind Beltoise. Was Nicolas Misslin, number 55. It's going fairly well, actually, Misslin. He's eighth at the moment, started ninth. It's just leapfrogged to Juinem. Juinem was eighth on the grid, but he's ninth now. It's going to be a tight battle between Juinem and Misland. And Juinem has just got back to eighth. He's just overtaken Misland. So Misland back to where he started in ninth at the moment. That was impressive then from Juinem. And Gaida is just behind them as well, the number 13. Gaida started 12th on the grid, but he's 10th and looking to close in on ninth and eighth. Chaminet. The gap now 5.4 seconds and rising between him and Andlauer. And Laurent Denarda, this is tight. Beltoise down to fifth, unbelievable. Well, Beltoise, what on earth has happened to Vincent Beltoise there? He's dropped two places in a matter of milliseconds. Oh, Beltoise, what on earth has he done? He's down to fifth. Laurent has gone third. But Beltoise back, incredibly back to third. He was down to fifth just a couple of seconds ago. It's going to be a tight battle. Yeah, Thomas Laurent with the attack on Beltoise. This is going to be interesting. There's a minor coming together there, and Beltoise Beltoise in second place, but he's pitting. So Milan Lauer is going to go back to second. Beltoise with a coming together against Thomas Laurent earlier on in this race. ...11 minutes to go in this season finale at the Paul Ricard circuit. Yeah, Vincent Beltoise is well down. Alexandre Juinem is up to 7th. He's having a good race. Misslin is 8th. And Gaidai is up to 9th. And Lindland is 10th, which is where he started. Pla still 5th. Or rather, he's up to 5th after starting 6th. Latour is sixth at the moment. But the big movers are Andlauer and Denada. Well, Andlauer still second, rather, but Denada is now up to third. He's overtaken Laurent. But Beltoise is the man that made the big error. He is well down now. But there's Lapierre. Lapierre and Koen Velters there. Beltoise is down in 12th place now. After originally starting third on the grid, it was a huge mistake from Beltoise. 34 seconds adrift of the leader now. That's not going to do his chances of an overall podium finish any good. It's Andlauer, 8.5 seconds behind Jaminet. But he's got a big gap to Denada. Denada just about holding off Laurent. But Jim Plaer as well is closing on Thomas Laurent. Florian Latour is in sixth place. He's got a 5 second gap, or just over 5 seconds, to Juenem, who is seventh. .6 seconds for Jaminet on Andlauer on lap 14. I think they are going to be the top two, barring a catastrophe. They'd have to crash out on their own if those two were to mess this up, but the battle is for third place. At the moment, though, Denada appears to have a full second on Thomas Laurent. Laurent seems to be struggling slightly at the moment. Jim Plaer is right behind him. Latour isn't too far away from Plaer. Mislat and Gaidai. That's a big battle for eighth at the moment. Gaidai closing in on Mislat. That's this, the season finale of the Porsche Carrera Cup France. There is your man. There is the champion, Jaminet. He's going to win again for the second time. He's already won race one at the Paul Ricard. He's going to win race two as well, barring an absolute calamity. He's got 10.8 seconds now on Andlauer. Andlauer not his closest challenger in the title race. Andlauer down in fifth, and I think he's going to stay there as well overall. Just the 11.1 seconds now for Jaminet on Andlauer. No problems at all for Jaminet. He's comfortable. Mislan and Gaidai is a real tussle. 8th place. At the moment, though, Mislat has about 0.8 seconds on Gaidai. 5 minutes to go. Joinem going well in seventh of the Tsunami RT team. Joinem going extremely well. He's 10th in the standings post Imola. Joinem had a nightmare in Imola. Didn't gain any points. Didn't finish the first race. Nothing in the second. In fact, he hasn't received any points since Zandvoort, when he came third in race two. No points in Le Mans, no points in Imola for Joinem, but he's going to get some today at the Paul Ricard. Laurens actually closed the gap on Donada. So third place, that battle for third goes on. 0.6 seconds now, the gap between Donada in third and Thomas Laurens in fourth. Donada well ahead of Laurens in the overall standings, but not in this race. It's tight, 0.6 exactly. And brilliant as well there. Well, Latour has gone fifth. Oh, Pla, what a mistake that was. Latour has passed him. Yeah, it was brilliant from Florian Latour. That's why he's in the top three in the overall standings. There's Jaminet. 1 minute left in the season finale at the Paul Ricard. And a season in which he has dominated. The battle between Mislat and Gaidai, the battle for seventh place at the moment. The battle for eighth, rather. Joinem in seventh. Mislat and Gaidai, that is tight, extremely tight. Lindland is just behind as well, 8th, 9th and 10th. You can see there that trio of cars. But I think that's the way they're going to finish. Joinem is going to finish 7th, Pla is going to finish 6th. Latour is going to finish 5th. Brilliant overtake from Latour over Pla earlier. But there is the Mr. Porsche Carrera Cup France, Jaminet. Twelve starts, 12 victories for Mathieu Jaminet in the Porsche Carrera Cup France. What an achievement for Jaminet. He has won every race. He's swept all before him this season. In Barcelona, at Spa, at Zandvoort, at Le Mans, at Imola, and now at the Paul Ricard. The man is invincible. Adlauer is going to finish second. Donada has won the battle for third over Latour. Vital points for Donada. as he looks to maintain second place overall. Latour's finished fourth. Pla. Well, Laurent as well is in there. Juinem raced very well in race two. Well, Mislint, Gaidai and Lindland, that was a real battle, but Mislint eventually came through and won that one. But there is the man of the moment, Mathieu Jaminet. This man can do no wrong in the GT Tour, in the Porsche Carrera Cup France. He has graced this circuit magnificently. Mathieu Jaminet, followed by Julien Andlauer, Geoffrey Denada. There's your podium in race two. It was a good day as well for Andlauer, a good weekend, two second place finishes. Denada got a fourth and a third, fourth in race one.
Arriver à réunir 25 Porsche, eh bien, dites-moi, c'est quand même un tour de force. Et à tous nos invités Porsche, nos 500 personnes hier, aujourd'hui et 450 hier, merci d'avoir été fidèles à la marque et que la fête commence.
Well, there's your man, Jaminet. Pumps the air with his fists. And why not? What a season. 12 starts, 12 victories for Jaminet of the Martinet by Almeras team. Brilliant from Jaminet.
Car allez voir les autres et qu'ils viennent chez nous, c'est véritablement le partage auquel et surtout on est attaché et très fier. Pour la troisième place.